Hi, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Leading from the Library, our Future Ready Librarian podcast series. This has been so fun to talk to so many people this season, and I'm really excited to talk to my friend down in Texas today, Clemencia. And so welcome to our podcast.
Hi, thank you for having me. I'm excited to talk to you about libraries and just everything in general.
I know, me too. And let's just start out by having you introduce yourself and tell where you work and what age you work with and where you're at.
Okay, so my name is Clemencia Ramirez, and I am an information literacy specialist, which is a fancy title for librarian, down in Houston, Texas. And I do work in Aldine Independent School District, and I am a ninth grade librarian. So my campus only has ninth graders.
Awesome. Yeah. How many kids do you serve then?
So right now we have about 680.
Wow, that's so nice. We have a school close by us in Iowa that is just a ninth grade building. And I always think that would be a really fun job just to work with. Yeah, like, I mean, and freshmen, that's a really important age too. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
yes, they're
a little different from when they're freshmen and when they're seniors. And so that's a great, I love that age. That's a really, really good age. Oh, that's awesome. So what has your year looked like for you then?
So it has been a lot different. Right now we have about half the students coming to school on campus and half of them are learning from home. So we have a lot of precautions and regulations in place and just different things just to keep everyone safe. So whereas before, I used to welcome students into the library in the mornings before class began, and I would have up to 80 students. They did not allow me to do that this year. So my mornings are pretty boring. I just stand in the hallway. But because there's only about half of the students on campus, when teachers bring their students to the library, it's okay. You know, there's about between 10 and 15 students in each class. I have hand sanitizers, so everybody sanitizes their hands as they come in. And we try to do things as normal as possible, I guess. But it is a lot different. I no longer have students coming in during lunches, you know, to eat their lunch and to hang out in the library, just because of safety reasons. And, you know, we're trekking along and it's getting done. And our virtual students, you know, they are allowed access to the library. I pull books for them as they request them and they drive by and pick them up. I know a lot of campuses are doing that. So we're doing that as well. And we're blessed to have a large digital collection as well.
That's good.
Come in handy. Yeah.
So. Yeah. And have they been accessing that a lot too?
They have. And we recently got access to our county public libraries digital collections. So like all of our students have a library card for the digital collection. So actually this week I've been going into classrooms and showing students how to log in and everything. So they like that.
Oh, that's awesome. Yeah, that's one thing that is such a blessing that we can now give, you know, help them get access to the public library, not just this year, but just as they get older, especially our high school kids and they go into college and they're just like really aware of everything that like public libraries have as well. I think that's a really big blessing in the last couple of years. I think that's awesome. Well, and I would love, the reason that I just am so excited also to talk to you today, and it's really great because, you know, working just with high school kids, like I work with all kids, but especially I think that my passion and probably where my like heart is the most with kids is just getting them connected to great things that they love, get them excited about things. And I'm so happy that you're going to tell us today about how you're getting your kids just really engaged and meeting them where they're at through Instagram and music. And so I can't wait to hear what you're doing.
So I don't think what I'm doing is innovative, but it's working.
Yeah.
So a little bit about my campus. I serve about 92% of Latinx students. And of our population, about 85% are economically disadvantaged. So they don't have libraries at home. They don't have a lot of the things that we assume sometimes that they have. And so I like to meet them where they're at and with what they have. So, and part of that is building relationships with them.
Yes.
Talking to them, which is one of the reasons why I love for them to come in the morning time, because it's just hanging out, you know, it's before school starts. They don't want to be in the cafeteria or in the gym. So yeah, they can come to the library and I start making conversations with them. So I first started with music with them, because that's all they want to do. They want to have their little earbuds in and listen to music all the time. So I'm like, okay, tell me what you're listening to, because I'm sure I'm not listening to that.
Yeah.
So they started telling me what they're listening to, and then I tell them, okay, you know what? I'm going to create a Google form, and y'all put on there all of the music that y'all like, and tell your friends about it and everything. So that was a big hit. They all provided lots and lots of music. So from that list, I was able to create playlists. So I would start playing music in the morning time when they were in the library. And so that started drawing in more students. And also during lunches, I would have the usual students or you know, the usual customers coming in for each lunch. So they got to create their own playlist of music, and we would play it for their lunch.
Oh, that's so fun. What would you play it? Like, would you put it together in like Spotify, or how would you find the music that they wanted?
So we started just with YouTube, and I would create YouTube playlists with the music that they liked.
Okay,
and,
awesome.
Yeah, and it was on PG.
That's so fun. That's a great idea. Yeah, that's a great idea.
And it was a way to draw more students into the library.
Yeah.
And once you have them in there, you know, hey, I'm going to talk, let's talk about this book, and, you know, just get them in there and then go on with that. So
wow,
that was very, very successful.
Yeah. Well, and kids, especially that age, they love, it's when they really start like also kind of defining themselves by like the music that they listen to. And I know in our house, we have our youngest one is a sophomore, and, you know, it's a great thing to have conversations with kids about, you know, like sometimes you're like in awe of every kind of their eclectic like music taste. And so, like you said, what a wonderful way to just spark those conversations with the kids and get them hooked so they want to talk about books.
Exactly.
That's great. Exactly. So now I know that something that you're doing too is not just like the music, but how are you using Instagram then to connect with them when it comes to meeting them where they're at?
Okay, so Instagram just started this year, and we just got the okay to create a campus Instagram account. And so we created it, and our students are following us. And we found that a lot of students are on Instagram, and they love to watch the stories because they automatically play from one to the next one. And of course, they love TikTok. But we don't have a TikTok account. But Instagram has come out with this Instagram Reels, which is short little video clips, just like TikTok. And so our kids love to watch that too. So I just started creating reels, book talks, or, you know, just different things from the library. And they think it's a hoot. And I'm like, you know what? That's great. So
awesome.
We recently got our new book shipment. And so I'm just making all these because it's a lot of like lip dubbing.
Yeah.
So I'll get a video and then I'll just pair it with a book and with one of the new books that we get. And they'll come down here and check out the book.
That's such a great idea. Like, I haven't used reels a lot yet, or even like I do sometimes, like my kids taught me how to do little boomerang things. And so I would love just to, like, for all of us who maybe haven't used that feature a lot, like just give us some tips or give us kind of the inside scoop of how you do that.
Okay. So I'm a newbie still, but, if you start watching reels, you'll start seeing, okay, this is popular right now. And it's basically music that you either say something with it or tie it back into a book or what message you're trying to get across. And one of the popular songs right now is a Shakira song with Black Eyed Peas, Girl Like Me.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, I haven't done a reel with that one, but I want to. And instead of, it says, they tell me that you're looking for a girl like me. I'm going to say for a book like me.
Oh, that's fine. That's perfect.
And so I think the best tip I can give is just to try it and to pretend that no one is watching.
Yeah, that's a great tip.
Yeah, that's what I tell myself. It's just me and my phone in front of me in the library, and nobody is watching.
Oh, well, and it's awesome because since you can't see the kids on, you know, there's restrictions and you have kids at home, it's like the perfect blend of being able to meet your kids, you know, where they're at, if it's in school or if it's at home. You know, if they're on Instagram, like meeting your community where they're at is, I think, the most important thing. And, you know, we all say, like, at school, we talk a lot about like the changes that we've had and how that's really going to make a difference in the future for good, you know, that what are the good things that are going to come out of this. And I've had so many ahas this year. And, you know, just listening to your story, it's like those little lights are going off in my head, like, oh, like, yeah, that's like a huge aha. I'm sure that's what it's been like for you and your kids too.
Definitely. Definitely. And, you know, we started the year before, I had all of the English teachers wanted me to do an introductory research lesson, and they all wanted it the same time. And I'm like, it's impossible for me to go to everybody's classroom. But then I was like, So we got on Google Meet and I taught the lesson from Google Meet in the library, and they all got to see it at the exact same time. And little did we know that,
right,
that was in our near future. Like, that was going to be a norm in our near future. So,
yeah, that's been a huge aha for me, actually, was, and we've done a lot of like Skypes with authors and illustrators and things over the years. But this year, when I was thinking about like, how am I going to do all of these different classes at once, but, you know, be really careful about how we were doing it, that's when like the light bulb went out for me. Like, I can just Zoom. I can use Google Meet. I don't have to do like multiple classes. I can do it all. And it's been going really well. Like, that has been just a real big, not only time saver, but it's just kind of nice that you can like tell everybody the same thing at once. And yeah. So I know that's been a huge, but it's kind of cool how we can use, you know, video, and librarians have always used, you know, multimedia, but mm-hmm. This is really, I think it's upping our game a lot. It's making us even more connected.
Definitely.
Yeah, it's fun too. Like, do you have kids? I have this group of kids that they always give me like recommendations, or they'll even send me like pictures. Can you put this on our Instagram, like our high school kids, if they've done something? Do you have input from your kids too with that?
Yes, we do. And our student council is actually very involved as well. So they'll post some stuff for us as well.
That's awesome. So. Yeah, it's, I mean, that's the fun part, like really getting them involved and just seeing like what they can do too. I love that piece.
Yes. And the only downfall is that we only have them for 1 year.
I know. And then they, well, hopefully you can inspire then the librarians that they have next to do this too.
Right.
That's true. Well, and just having them follow, like we have kids who follow like the hashtag, like Bookstagram and Readersagram. And I think that are really big readers, especially, and who use Instagram. It's fun to see like even the ideas that they get from like publishers or other librarians or people that are posting. And so maybe you'll inspire them to do that too.
And to continue following us.
Yeah. And continue following you. Just think how creative you'll be over the years.
Oh, I hope.
I love it. I just love that. Oh, well, you're always so inspiring to talk to. And I love following the things that you do in your library. And I'm sure that in Texas, you guys get out probably the end of May, first part of June.
Yes, the students get out that Thursday before
Labor Day. Yeah, Memorial Day. Yeah, that's about like us too. And so, you know, we're starting to think about summer reading, and we're starting to think about, you know, how we can just, especially this year, just really support our kids in the summer too. And so as we like kind of wrap up, is there anything that you are going to do this summer, or ideas that you can leave us with that we can do too?
So in the past, my principal has always set aside money for me to buy paperback books. We are a Title I school, so we do get Title I funding. And with those paperbacks, they are used in the classroom throughout the year, but at the end of the school year, we let the kids take them home. It's because paperbacks are considered consumables. So they're allowed to take them home. And I've taken my little car and packed it up with books and just gone to the neighborhoods that our students come from. But now our district is actually going to have a book bus for us to drive through our district and distribute books, you know, and I'm excited for that. I've been wanting that for years. That's why I would get in my little car and do a mini version of that.
That is so cool. Congratulations. I have been hearing so many great stories about more and more districts getting book buses, and I am just like, I just want to do that too. Like what a great thing. And it's something that will truly make a difference, like for those kids, you know, when it comes to just being able to read and just connect to people, that those faces that they know. And again, you know, those conversations that you can have and kind of check in with the kids too.
Exactly. And it's not just to provide books to kids, but resources for parents and, you know, maybe some art activities and just different things to do throughout the summer. And my students are in an area of Houston where the public library is right in the center of everything. So our public library has a lot of activities that we partner with them to bring to the students. So we motivate students to attend the public library for their weekly teen activities.
Oh, that's so cool. You got some lucky kids there, girl.
Yeah.
I love it.
I love to serve them too.
Yeah. Isn't it a blessing? Being a librarian is the best job in the world.
Yes. Actually, just did a video on Instagram reel that said, it was a song that says, I'm on vacation every day because I love my job.
Oh, that's...
The kids got a hoot out of that one.
I love it. I'm going to look for that one. And if people want to look up where you're at on Instagram, what is your Instagram?
So my Instagram handle is at Libros with Love. And yeah, and our school is Aldi9_AISD.
Awesome. Well, and I will put that in the description too, so people then can grab that and follow all the awesome things you're doing.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you, Clemencia. It's always so great to see you and just to be inspired by your stories and your work. So thanks for everything that you do.
Likewise. Thank you for having me.
You are so welcome. And thanks everybody for joining us for another one of our podcasts. And just a huge shout out to our friends at Follett for supporting this and all that you do for librarians. And so until next time, have a great day. And I can't wait to see what everybody does now with all of their Instagram and inspiring your kids too, just like Clemencia. Thank you for joining us for the Future Ready Librarian podcast, Leading from the Library. I would like to also thank our sponsor, Follett Learning, for their amazing continued support.